much for having me. I had a great time working with those of you in the cello section today. You guys sound really fantastic. So I'm Larry Stomberg. I am the cello professor at the University of Delaware and do a lot of other sort of chamber music and playing around in this region as well. So this program is, for me, I'm thinking of it as a retrospective of different current American voices in music. And the oldest thing on the program that I'm going to play for you today was written in 1995. The newest was written in 2018. So it's a lot of recent things from people who I've had some experience with personally. I'll explain the final pieces that I'm playing, and others that have been sort of brought into my attention from colleagues of mine who played their music. So I'm going to start off with a work by a woman named Nancy Carroll. And Nancy is actually a choir director, church choir director down in Jacksonville, Florida. And her music was brought to my attention by colleagues of mine in Philadelphia who were championing her music and shared this piece with me, which is called Spiritual, simply the title of it. It is sort of a theme in variations, but more of a fantasy on famous spiritual, gonna tell God all my troubles when I get home. And it starts off with that tune in a somewhat punctuated way. And then each of the sort of variations and explorations of the theme explore different ranges of the cello and different ways that the instrument can have conversation with itself. So I hope you enjoyed it. It's been a wonderful experience to get to know this one particularly. Thank you. a bit different. This is a work that, this is the old work on the program coming up here, written in 1995 by composer Augusta Reed Thomas, who is, I think, right now just about in her late 50s or around 60. She was has been a good friend of cellist Scott Puckstall, who's a cello professor down at University of South Florida in Tampa. And even though I haven't met Scott, we have lots of sort of intersecting people that we know. And their friendship and collaboration has produced a lot of work that she's written or has transcribed for him. And this is one that was written specifically for Scott, and like the rest of us get to play it too. It's a piece called Spring Song, about a 5-minute work, and I'll read what's written in the notes on the music. A 5-minute piece that celebrates the lyrical, long line, expressive, and elegant characteristics of the cello. The double stop passages evoke a carillon of bells, all ringing in a flurry atop a large cathedral. At times, the piece is very intimate, at other times, bold and energized. Much of the piece is in the high register, so that when it finally falls down to the low C string, one feels as if one has landed back on Earth, if only for a little while. So I think you'll hear the carillon of the bells as this very clangorous type of moment a little bit into the next. Cello is the perfect instrument to showcase through this fascinating set of variations on a theme of universal unity. The cello's range and tone evoke the baritone voice, and its facility in contrapuntal playing allows for polyphony in the manner of Bach's cello suite. The theme, sounding like a spiritual, is actually the final chorus of the composer's Earth Rise, a profoundly bold cantata using Schiller's Ode to Joy as text, and full of allusions to all four movements of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. Hailstorm's Earth Rise features a festival chorus singing in German, alternating with an African-American chorus singing in English with vernacular verve. The choruses ultimately unite to end the cantata together with Draw the Sacred Circle Closer, a translation of lines from Schiller's Ode to Joy. The variations are entitled Variations on Draw the Sacred Circle Closer. So you'll hear that tune, which is from his orchestral choral work. And then there's a set of five variations of differing character, differing levels of seriousness, and it ends with a bit of fun.
Thank you.
finished with three works. The Hailstorm was written in 2014. And I'm going to finish with three works that were written in 2018 that I actually commissioned. Back then, around 2017 or so, I was planning on doing a cycle, as they call it, of Bach cello suites. He wrote six suites for solo cello. And I was planning on doing that as sort of a bucket list thing for cello players to do all six. And I did it over two nights. But I had been thinking about doing something. I live in Wilmington, Delaware. And I was thinking of doing something involved with the city there, maybe going around to different churches. And it was a period of time in 2017 where the world seemed to be changing and it didn't seem to be quite such a friendly place anymore. And I felt, having moved into the city of Wilmington with my family, hoping that they could experience the sort of range of experiences and the diversity of people that a city offers, I found over that time that as often happens in too many communities, that we wall each other off. So this neighborhood is that neighborhood, and that neighborhood is that neighborhood. You don't go from one place to the next. And there seemed to be a lot of really good things happening in my town that weren't getting celebrated, or at least weren't getting acknowledged as much as I thought they should. So my Bach project quickly turned into something where I worked with a couple of composers, two women, Maz Swift, who's a violinist in New York, and Melissa Rose, who's a violinist in San Francisco. And I asked them to write companion pieces to each of the Bach cello suites. But in addition to that, I wanted it to also reflect these different places around my city of Wilmington, Delaware, where I was meeting people and seeing what they were doing, whether it was incredible food pantry works at churches, helping immigrants and refugees. There was one organization that was a retraining program for the recently incarcerated who were coming back into the job force. And all of these places were doing great things. So I had conversations with these people, and I actually recorded the interviews that I had with them, asking them about their lives and what their hopes were, what their fears were about where they lived and about the world in general. That all got sent to the composers, and they wrote these incredible set of six pieces. I'm gonna play three of them for you today. And I have with me my little Bluetooth speaker that has some of the interview snippets from these different places. And I will explain each one as I go along here. I'm going to do the first three, which reflect and respond to the first cello suite of Bach, the second cello suite, and the third cello suite. But they also respond to these places and these people in my hometown. So the first one is you'll hear an interview with a fellow who works at a place called the Kingswood Community Center, which is in the Riverside section of Wilmington, and caters to young and old alike and everywhere in between, and is a safe haven in that part of the town, and it has just some incredible people working for it and what they do for the community, both in reaching and outreaching. And this is, I believe his name is Craig, who's talking about his place here, and you'll hear him say this, but the name of the work that I'm going to play right afterwards is called A Very Good Place to Be. Not hearing it, so I must have seen it turn itself. Probably get after inactivity one second. Technology is great except when it's not. There we go. Oh, here.
Seems like a good place to be here.
Yes, it is. It's a very good place to be. This environment is great. The environment is great. The people here are great.
What's your favorite part of being here, working here?
It's just everything. I like seniors. I like to deal with the kids. I like to see the future. The future is bright here. You see the kids, and they coming up. Everything's good about this place.
the second work is dedicated both to the D minor suite, the second suite of Bach. The cellist here, you'll hear a little bit of the maybe of the G of that suite, and also to the Hanover Presbyterian Church, which is just down the street from where I live, or from where my house is. It's just a couple blocks apart. And this is a place that does a lot of work with immigrant and refugee families at a time when that's challenging. And really wonderful people. They also serve a lot of folks in the neighborhoods around the church. The voice that you're going to hear is a member of the youth group of that church, talking about his upbringing in Wilmington and how it sort of made him maybe grow up a little bit faster than he would have otherwise grown up.
I'll be honest with you, it can be a rough place to live sometimes. I mean, I know there's other places in the world that are rough too, but it can be rough. It's definitely one place for somebody to really learn and really be opened up to how the world actually is. I mean, we're a small state, but you know, this area, you know, you should really learn to grow up kind of fast, I guess you could say. A lot of life lessons, you know, can be learned real quick. But at the end of the day, it's home. You know, I was born and raised here, so it's home to me.
And the name of the word is flow.
Thank you.
The third and final piece that I'll play for you today is dedicated to the third cello suite of Bach. Again, cello players, you will hear instead of the scale going down, you will hear a scale going up to start the piece. And so it's very much in the vein of that work. And this is a work that is dedicated also to the people of an organization called the Hope Mission Achievement Center, which is that program I mentioned before that is a re-entry program for the recently released from being incarcerated. And I learned a lot from these folks just in the amount of sort of hope that they brought to their new lives. But as well, there were some who were still very embittered by their experiences, and that was a very, you know, interesting and moving for me as well. The voice you're going to hear in the interview before the work, which by the way is called "In the End, We All Just Dance It Out." It's a fellow named Hanif, who actually was at the time, he moved on to other things. He was working at that achievement center. And it's sort of his vision. I think I asked him, "What is your hope for the future?" And so this is his response.
What gives me hope is accomplishing each and every one of my goals. Every time I accomplish a goal, every time I reach a new success, it gives me hope that things can get better. You know, I have this vision that one day. A lot of people who have been suffering in their lifetime will get to enjoy a more prosperous life. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that seems like it could be hopeless,
yeah.
But as I, one more person, become better, as I become better as an individual, it gives me hope that one day we'll have less people suffer.
Thank you. Bye.